Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Paper Mario. In the last episode, we combed the desert and found the dry ruins. In this episode, we're gonna go into it. Oh no. What do you gotta say, Gumbario?
Listen, that's the entrance to dry ruins. It's called the Illusion Ruin.
What?
Nobody could find this Plages. Nobody could find this Plages, but weed.
Anyway. I'm pretty sure nobody calls this the Illusion Ruin. I think you made that up. Oh no, it's a poisonous pokey. Why didn't I heal at the heart block outside? This is a pokey mummy. Pokey mummies are pokies that dried out and became mummies that went to live in the ruins. Holy crap, what a run-on sentence. Okay, so they're basically the exact same thing, except they can poison you! I didn't even think about that. Maybe I actually should have picked up that tasty tonic. I forgot about that, holy crap. Oh man, I feel like a grade A dunce. Okay, well I gotta use Koi Camera, because I'm gonna go back outside and actually go use that heart block in a second anyway, so. Nice. Nice. Very nice. Look a pretty nice. Yeah, I wanna get Meta for this area is basically gonna be find both kinds of enemies that you fight in here as quickly as possible, so that I can get them both tattled and take Gumbario out of the front, because he's not gonna be all that useful in this area. Well, the thing is, he will be against the other enemies, but not against the Pokies, which he can't attack at all, which basically shine sparks. There. What do I have equipped for my badges anyway? I don't have... Oh, I should actually definitely equip. I don't need Speedy Spin, really, because we're indoors. Power Jump is going to be, like, mediocre to have. What else do we have? What else do we got? I do want Spin Out, or Chill Out, because Chill Out is going to be useful here. Dizzy Attack will be useful, too, but obviously, the more enclosed environments of this area make it not as important to have... Jeez. Okay, you know what let's do? You know what let's do? Let's use Bombette. Because you already tattled these guys, so it doesn't even matter. Oh, but shit, she can't attack these guys from the front. Fuck. Arrgh. Damn it. Excuse me. Oh, jeez. I wish I could have picked up, like, Power Smash. That would have been really nice to have. But I don't think you can find it until after this chapter. Which sucks. It sucks bad. I hate it bad. Okay, now just... I can't believe that actually worked. That had no right to work. I know, I'm wasting time. I don't know if this is even the most efficient way to do this. Oh my gosh, there's three of them. Oh boy. I got that stopwatch, I guess. I do have another sleepy sheep. You know, I'm gonna use it. I gotta use these eventually. What better time than this when I need to make a partner switch against more than one enemy? Thank you. Three turns. Golly. Apparently, like... I don't know. I was pretty sure that you could wake these guys up prematurely by hitting them, but I don't know. Crimson Space Angel didn't think so, so maybe. I didn't need to use Quick Hammer there. They're gonna be asleep for like two more turns. That was a waste of FP. A bad waste. You know what I should be doing? If I end up having to fight that... Ooh! Thank you, Merly. I love you. She's gonna double my star points. To 12. So officially, you roll a 12. Holy crap, name that LP. Yeah, I'll just dizzy spin them so that I can make them dizzy. Now, that doesn't actually do anything for this fight. In fact, it's pretty much useless because I'm gonna attack this guy anyway, because it's not like I can attack the back guy. Because these guys are all spiky. I can only attack the front guy when they're all spiky. Thank you. That
damage dodge, man. I'm telling you, that badge is invaluable. Oh, my stupid ear. I've got, like, this zit or whatever the fuck you want to call it. It's not a zit or a pimple yet. It's, like, the... It's, like... You know, it's, like, the beginnings of one. But it's, like... It's in the inside of my ear, man. That's like the worst place for that, for those things to fucking show up, because they change the shape of your inner ear. So my fucking earbuds don't fit as well, and they make it hurt when I try to make them fit as well. It's like, come on, man. I don't care about tattling in here. I should, because it's like, I get it. It's ironic because of the whole tuxedo thing. The sound those buttons make sounds like somebody going, it's scary. Alright, so that's how that works. We can empty sand into a lower floor.
Fool! You have ignored my warning, haven't you, you fool? You will fall to my legions and become a member of the Saints!
Okay. I am so sorry for that voice, but you know what? It's too much fun. Man, it's doing this again. That weird, like, camera wiggity thingy. This is supposed to be a little cute, but mean. 3-2-2. For if I don't work very well against these hard heads. Yeah. Okay, I'll hit this guy. These guys might be able to attack and get up in the same turn. I don't think so, though. No. But as long as you're in a fight with only two of these guys, you can stun lock them easily. Just like Koopas, basically. He's basically Shine Spark. Yeah, just finish him off, Goombario. That sound will never stop being weird. The sound it makes when he uses head bonk. I want that. Give it to me. Oh, this part. Okay, when I first played this game as a kid, I didn't realize that you could change partners out of battle. Because it was like, C right? That's awkward. I didn't even try pushing C right, because why the fuck would C right? Because I was only familiar with the C with like C as an analog stick, as the C stick, because my first consoles were like Xbox and GameCube. I think I actually want to go into the lower room here first. No, okay, we're good. One of these rooms has a star piece in it that you don't want to like miss out on. I don't think it's actually possible to miss it. Maybe, but I don't remember. It might be in a room that's filled with sand at first that you then empty. Like, it might be in this room, and then when the sand empties, it'll reveal the star piece. But anyway, yeah, I didn't realize that you could change partners out of battle, because I didn't realize that you could push C right, because I didn't think of C right as buttons. It seemed weird to me, there it is, that you would push a direction on the C stick as a button, not to open a menu, nonetheless, you know, like, you can't use the C stick for menus, the start button is for menus. You know, it was just weird. But so what I had to do, because I didn't know you could switch party members out of battle, so what I had to do was I had to like leave the dungeon to get the enemies to respawn, and then come back into this room, fly across. Well, I didn't know what to do, because I had to fly across the gap with Paracarry, but then I had to use Bombette to break open the wall, and I couldn't figure out how to do it. I think eventually I did figure out that you could change party members out of battle, but, like, jeez, man. Ah, I get more badge points. I know, Scrublord, Clock. What's the word I'm looking? Complacent gaming syndrome. Like, to the max here. Spike Shield would be, like, I don't really know if that would be that useful in here, because I'm not, because, you know. I mean... Like, so Mario can jump on mummy pokies other than the first one in the row. So what? Nobody else can do that, and it doesn't work for the party members. Like, Goombario and Paracarry still wouldn't be able to do anything. I guess I didn't really need more badge points, eh? I'll throw in multi-bounce and, I don't know, hammer throw. I need a key. Oh, shit. Big old stone block. That's weird. What is... Hey, Kimbaria, what do you got to say about this area? This area's pretty cool, right? There's a great view of the desert from the upstairs floor. The farther down we go, the cooler it'll get. It'll get darker, too, though. Should we go down there? Well, sure. I don't see why not. We're gonna have to go down there eventually. We have to explore the whole area, man. Okay, here's the key. Here's the key!
Is it like a video game?
Alright, open the door. With those skinny-ass arms. Well, Mario doesn't have skinny-ass arms, I tell you what. Mario's got big fat arms. Big meaty trunk arms. Okay, so what's the deal here? There's, a question mark block. Oh, no, here's that part in Tim's LP where he played Final Fantasy IV. The run music for Final Fantasy IV for some reason. I still don't understand why he played that there. That's not like an especially dramatic moment. That kind of fed into this problem. I don't want to get on the soapbox here, but I had like an issue with Tim's LP of Paper Mario when it was first going on. That like, oh, I actually have to fight these guys. Shit. Yeah, I had a bit of an issue with Tim's LP of this game when it first came out. Oh man, I gotta switch out to Mario. Sloopers! It's a good thing I equipped Quake Hammer. I didn't! I had it equipped already. It's fine. Okay. Was that, like, for the first, like, third of his LP, it seemed like he wasn't really given much respect to the game. Like, he was putting in music everywhere instead of, like, oh, I gotta spice this up because nobody's actually interested in watching this, you know? That's how it felt, anyway, but I know it wasn't. He was just trying to make things more interesting. But that's exactly the thing. It's like, well, what? It's not interesting enough already? You know, you're finally playing this game people have wanted you to play for years. It's not interesting enough by itself. You gotta put more music in there? But I don't know. Maybe I'm just being dumby. Whee! Ah! I wasn't ready for that, man. Why do these guys only ever shoot, like, throw their whoop? I'm gonna use Quake Hammer again. I got the FP. Yeah, the really annoying thing about this is that there's no good efficient way to kill these guys. If, like, the only good way to first strike them is with Bombette. That's the only way that does any more than, like, one damage. Ah, come on, man. Boom! What? Dude! There we go, finally. Oh, it's only one. Only the one. Oh, you know what we can do now? We can also show off this hammer throw. Hit one enemy with a hammer, no matter where the enemy is. You can actually use it to knock these swoopers down. Y'all! And it feels really good to use, too. It's got, like, a really strong impact. Yeah, I get it. Ugh. But, unfortunately, Bombette still can't attack the super. But, hey, that was pretty well handled, I'd say. That was pretty, you know, dishwasher? Yes. Boom. What do you mean they didn't hit him? Sir, you can't just randomly stop and start at different times. Ugh. What a pain in the fucking ass. Ah, I should've used Bombette first. Fuck you. Oh my gosh, there's so many battles in this place. Jeez. Like, we're never gonna finish this crazy world. I tell ya. I feel like I should still, like, go all the way through the dungeon in this episode, though. Okay, that causes a key to appear. Yeah, okay. And I think this next room has something very important in it. Yeah, I wanna finish this whole dungeon in this episode. It shouldn't take that much longer. Is this the room, right? Oh my gosh, what the hell? Where the... How big is this place? Doesn't this go to that... Yeah, this goes to a super block, I think. Yeah. Let's upgrade Bomb Head. Fuck yeah. To learn Power Bomb to destroy grounded enemies. Now it might seem like, oh, what are you doing? People who know this game might say, oh, what are you doing upgrading Bombette? You need her for the boss. You need an upgraded partner for the boss, and Bombette can't attack the boss. Well, no, but Goombario can. Yet again, with underestimating Goombario. Okay, I think where we want to go is up here, across this guy. I love the lighting in here. Like, look how pretty the lighting in this game is. Like, this is N64, man, and this game looks good. It still looks good. They really...
Oh, wait! Come on, don't go in that room! Oops. I mean... Flee now while you still can! If you continue, you'll feel a horrible curse!
Okay. You silly bean. Jeez. Okay. This is so stupid. This hat is so stupid. If you can name that comic, you're pretty good. So this room is kind of a pain in the ass. There's actually a super secret badge you can find in here that I didn't even know existed for the longest time. I'd heard tale of how to find it, but I couldn't figure out how to do it. Like, I didn't understand. So I come up here, and then cross over here and push this button. And that switches these two purple staircases. And then we can climb back up on the left. Oh, it's actually already lined up. Huh. Okay, then what the hell would you ever use that one on the right for? Anyway, now we're across here, but be careful here. There's actually a secret. If you stand on here and walk around... Right? Huh? This is where it is, right? Isn't it? I'm pretty sure there's no wallable bomb here. I thought this was where it was. Maybe not? Not there. Oh, there it is. Man, that's like twice as hidden. Holy crap. And with that, you get the Slow-Go badge. It makes Mario unable to run. His pace becomes very slow. Well, it's basically garbage, but would you not totally sleep in here? Like, just huddled up behind this chest, like in the corner here? Yeah. That would be so... That is such a cuck-a-feeling room. Anyway, now we can fall all the way back down. Land on top of a giant-ass chest, what could possibly be in here? Holy shit! You got the Super Hammer! The attack power of Mario's hammer increases! Fuck. Yes. We can now destroy stone blocks, and our first strike will do 2 damage. I think it'll do 2 damage. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm almost 100% sure of that. It'll now do 2 damage, but of course we can't... Still can't use it to break to beat these guys. Because they have 2 defense. Oh my gosh, what the hell is this? That's a lot of guys. I'll use a nutty cake. And then Goombario can just, like, I don't know, pontificate. But Goombario can just sit and pontificate. I think Quake Hammer will actually still do just 2 damage, which kind of sucks, but... I want to use Quake Hammer with this new hammer. I'm pretty sure it'll still do 2 damage. Yeah. Pretty lame. Pretty lame that upgrading your hammer doesn't improve the power of that. I mean, if they really wanted to, they could have made it do only 1 damage with your basic hammer. I wouldn't have been surprised if they had done that. But with this new hammer, we can now pierce the defense of these Buzzy Beetles without even having to flip them over. Still not enough damage to KO him right away, but, well, Mario can take care of that. He can take care of another man. Not that had anything to do with what I was saying. Ow. Man, I suck. Holy crap. Okay, let's not be stupid here. We're kind of running low on health. I have hot shrooms, but I would want to consume more FP before I use those. But it might be time to use one anyway. Oh, thank you. Never mind. We're fine.
Turn back, thief! Your time is running out! If you do not retreat, you'll be in grave trouble! I do not lie! You will regret it!
Okay, weirdo. Jeez. What the heck is this? Oh, hey, it's a block that I can break. It's a Brock I can break. What does this do? Oh, it makes some cute little stairs appear that fit together so nicely like little Tetris pieces. Little Tetronimos. We got the Ruins Key. And we got some Buzzy Beetles that I don't feel like fighting. Holy shit, I'm gonna die. Oh, we got a map here. That is so cool. Fine, I'll fight you. Oh, it's a good thing I actually did this, because now I can use this Quake Hammer. And then if I take another hit, I will be in perfect shape to use a Hot Shroom. So I'll just attack you guys. Do I have Payoff equipped? I think I do have Payoff equipped still. So I'll basically purposefully take damage here. So that's perfect. And now I use a Hot Shroom in battle. Get the refund from that, which is lots of money. Payoff increases the money I get the more damage I take in battle. Goombario can finish off the Buzzy Beetle, and then I'll just take a hit from the Swooper, because who cares? I actually tried to guard that, and I fucked it up, so that was good. That was exactly what I was planning to do, actually. I was just gonna... I didn't say anything, but I was gonna go for the guard there, and if I fucked it up, well, then fine. If I get hit, I get more coins. If I don't, I don't get... If I don't, I take less damage, you know? Win-win. I do have that equipped, right? Yes, I do. Okay. I thought I did. I thought maybe they died. Okay, so now in here, next to the super block, there's actually a thing here. Oh no, and it makes a stone chunk! Aww! It's a mini boss. Get some more toilet paper. Let's tattle it. This is a stone chunk. Who guards the treasure in his room? He's made of stone. Duh! Duh! His job is supposedly crush a coconut. I don't know about you, but I don't want to become a snack. No, me neither. Doop beep boop ba doo ba doo. Boop beep doop ba doo ba doo. So they only have one defense, but that's still... Oh, I love you! That's not enough to protect from this increased attack power hammer. Check this shit out. Boom! Holy shit. Well, you're fast. I love the way these guys look, like, with their chain... Like, in the Thousand Year Door, the chain chomps you encounter in that game are all tethered to the ground. But these ones are all loose and wild, and that is cool. It's really cool. But they're not so bad. You know what I always thought was weird about this game? Because I played the sequel first. And in the sequel, the star point bar at the end of battle only goes up to 9. Because when you get to 10, it makes a big star piece thing that goes outside of the bar. But in this game, they have room in the star piece bar at the end of battle for 10 star piece... Not star pieces, but star points. The bar at the end of battle in this game has room for 10 star points, but you don't need that. You don't need room for 10 star points, because after 9, it forms a big star point. Did I say star pieces again? It forms a big star point that goes outside the bar, so it's weird that they have room for 10 in this game. In the sequel, they smartened up and made it only have room for 9. I'm not even sure if anybody has any idea what the fuck I'm talking about, but... Let's fight you, and that makes a stone chomp appear, and we can't leave the room until he's dead. But that's fine, because he's active, which means we can use Bombette to get a first strike and kill one of them right away, because it'll do 5 damage. Minus 1 is still 4, so boom. So wait, it actually did 5? Oh, because she's evolved, or not evolved, but, leveled up. It does more damage now. Probably does 6. That's awesome. Just when I thought I couldn't love Bombette anymore. Yeah, the thing about partners in this game is that, and I think even in the sequel they did this, when you level up a party member, like, okay, when I level up Mario's hammer, it goes from, you know, 1 damage, 2 with the action command, to 2 damage, 4 with the action command. But partners don't get the same boost. Partners go from 1 damage, 2 with the action command, to 2 damage, 3 with the action command, which is obviously not as significant of an increase. It's not a big deal, obviously, but it's just weird. And that's why party members like Goombario are effective, is because he hits twice for 1, they can't buff him the same, like, small amount. They have to buff him to do 2 damage with each hit. I guess they could have made it so, like, the first hit does 2 and the second hit does 1. That might actually have been pretty cool. That would have had flavor. It would have been a flavorful... I don't know why I think like this, but it would have been cool. It would have been spicier from a game design standpoint to have, like, one of his hits do more damage, have the first hit that you actually push the A button on do more damage than the second hit that you don't. I need to go look at the map again. I don't remember is this where the map was? Well, kinda. I wanna go up there, man. What's up here? That looks cool, whatever's up there. Like, I'll totally sleep up there if I knew what was up there. It's probably safe, right? Okay. There is something there. I have to empty sand into that room. Oh, they actually show you that secret room with Slogo in it. Near that pink dot, that's where I got the super hammer. Okay, where do I find the... Shit. Ugh, I don't want to fight your ass, go away. I want to finish this dungeon so I can get to the save block and cliffhang it before the boss. Come on, man. So somewhere around here, there should be, directly above that room, should be a room with sand in it that I can drain? But I don't know, that doesn't sound familiar. Well, I should have looked at the map, I guess. Okay, so here we are. We're, like, above everything. Oh, fuck. I don't know. I mean, all it is there's some door I just happen to have not gone through yet. That's all it is. Do I have a key? I do! I have a key! Oh, I'm so stupid! Okay, well, I have a key, so that's all we gotta do. Come through here to this room with the 3 chain chomps. Come in here. Open this door. See, it's not rocket science. We push this button, which drains the sand, into that room where we found the Tetris stairs. And allows us to cross that stretch to the last stone chomp room. And it also gives us a combination here. Triangle, star, moon. Sun, moon, puny, star. Triangle, star, moon. Alright. Got the lunar stone. And then they come to life! Oh! Man, Mario's so shocked. He's so surprised. Oh, you know what let's do? Okay, let's kick some ass here. I can finish this in one turn. Watch this. 6 FP, explode to all enemies on the ground. Oh my gosh. It's impossible to love a bomb on more. So many coins, man. Holy cow. Okay, there we go. Let's get out of here. Let's go find the save block, because I know there's one around here somewhere. There's one before the boss, and the boss is a hop, skip, and a jump away. Okay, so this one, put in the lunar stone. This one, you put in the diamond stone. Diamonds! And here we put in the pyramid stone. Whoa. I love when Mario does this, when he runs around flailing his arms. They just show, like, 2 different sprites of him carrying something, like, with his hands out in front and with his hands up above his head. It looks so stupid. Whoa. The music changed. Oh, that's so cool. That's so cool that the music changed. It's so cool. There's nothing over here. Just a door. What's in here?
This is your final warning! Enough of this foolishness, leave at once!
Nah. I'm not gonna leave at all. I'm not gonna leave one bit. I'm not gonna leave one bitch. Next time on Paper Mario, guys, we take on the boss of Chapter 2. See you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye!